Hi students, this is Kameshwari from Nalaneb Singhared Education Society Group of Institutions. My subject watershed management. Today we are going to discuss about check dams. What is definition of check dams? What are the types of check dams? Check dams are yet another type of spatial water harvesting structures. These are temporary structures of vegetation, stone and brushwood are permanent masonry structures using stones, bricks and cement. By using the vegetation or stone and brushwood are permanent structures are structures using stones, bricks and cement. Constructed across the streams to arrest soil erosion and harvest the runoff water. The height of the check dam is generally less than 2 meters. The stored water is used for irrigation and replacement of nearby groundwater, reservoir and wells in order to meet the household water requirement. The construction and maintenance of check dams need less technical knowledge, less skilled labor and low capital investment and minimal maintenance. And what are the comes to types of check dams? The first one is temporary check dams. So temporary check dams are, we can use brushwood dams and also wooden planks. Figure shows the temporary check dams. Temporary check dams are brushwood check dams helps to reduce the velocity of runoff water and decrease the soil loss from the channels. Such dams are made up of brushwood, wooden planks and logs placed in a single row or a double row placed across the shallow channels. The depth is very less, placed in a shallow channels. The logs are generally 8 to 10 centimeters diameter, 1.5 meters to 2 meters in height and dug into the soil at a depth of 50 centimeters with a spacing of 40 centimeters. And next one is live vegetative check dams. This are we are placed a trees, scrubs, grass across the channels. That means the live vegetative check dams are constructed to construction of vegetation such as trees, scrubs and grasses across the channel to retain the runoff and silt. The vegetation The vegetation used in check dams include tall grasses as Lantana, Camara and grass planted on gully sides alternative basal and top ends. So such an arrangement helps to prevent soil erosion, reduce the speed of water flow, and prevent the soil of sediment. And next ones are permanent check dams and also sandbag check dams. So permanent check dams are, we are constructed by using masonry and also rocks. By using masonry and rocks, the permanent check dams helps to retain runoff or silt, increase the infiltration of water, and increase the water level in the aquifer. This figure shows the masonry. That means permanent check dam. Such dams are made up of stones, boulders, and rocks of 8 to 12 inches in diameter and packed with galvanized iron wire mesh. Sandbags. So in this type of dams, the sandbags are filled with the sand, are placed across a channel, ditch, or a drainage to arrest the soil of silt and water in the stream. And one more thing, another one is dugout ponds. What is dugout ponds? Here, excavated pond, surface pond, spring pond, and half stream storage pond. What is excavated pond? Excavated pond means slope. Excavated pond. These ponds are well defined. These ponds are well defined. Here, assume excavated pond. This is the trees and slope of land, water will be infiltrate. And this is also another tree. This is slope of land. These ponds are well defined shape and size, and their location on the farm is based on the prevailing slope of the land. For instance, if the slope of the land is towards left side of the field, the pond is built in the left side of the plot. If the plot has multiple slopes, then pond should be built in a location where maximum water can drain into the pond. If the plot is size and shape located farm based on the prevailing slope of the land. If the slope of land towards left side of the field, so we can construct a pond towards left side. And surface pond. What is surface pond? Such ponds are built on the local depression or lowest part of the farms. It is not provided with an inlet but has a outlet. This type of surface ponds, it consists of an inlet but it is not provided with an inlet but has no outlet. And spring pond are creep feed ponds. Such ponds are built at the foothills of the hill areas where excessive precipitation results in soil saturation and the surface flow of water is discharged as base flow at the surface of the foothills. This will be constructed in hilly areas. And also another one is half stream storage pond. So these type of structures are built by the sides of the streams and provided with the pipes for the flow of water from the stream into the ground. That is stream into the ground. So this type will be half stream means this will be comes from the these are the trees. So we are connected a pipes that will reach us to the ground surface, ground level. Okay. This is the off-seat, off-stream storage pond and also excavated pond, surface pond, spring pond. Okay. And also, what is difference between farm pond and percolation pond? So, farm ponds are constructed in arable land as a small surface storage facility for rainwater. They are provided with an inlet and outlet for collection of maximum surface runoff. What is percolation pond? The storage water is used for drinking water and livestock. And also large multiple purposes storage facilities constructed in a natural stream or a gully. It is generally constructed in soils that have high infiltration rates, high infiltrate, especially on the uncultivated land adjoining the streams.